State lawmakers did it right after a tough-talking Governor Murphy blasted them for sticking to what he called their old ways. They approved a budget. The governor said he would not sign it. The latest now, as chief political correspondent, Michael Aaron joins us here in the studio. Michael?
Michael, as we head into the weekend, the budget has hit a serious impasse. There are two budgets, actually, the governor's and the legislature's. The difference between them is in how they raise taxes. Murphy would hike the income tax on million-dollar earners and restore the sales tax back up to 7%. The legislature would increase the corporate business tax instead, temporarily. Governor Murphy, Senate President Sweeney, and Assembly Speaker Coughlin met twice yesterday but could not resolve the difference. So last night, the leaders went ahead and voted on their version of the budget. The Senate approved it narrowly, 21-17. A few hours later, over in the Assembly, the same budget bill was approved, 46-28. Two Republicans voted for the Democratic budget in the Senate, Kip Bateman and Kristen Corrado. Four Democrats voted against their party leaders, Nia Gill, Ron Rice, Nick Sacco, and Jeff Van Drew, and Democrat Brian Stack abstained. Governor Murphy has promised to veto the legislature's budget. After last night's vote, we got some Senate reaction.
Our goals in this budget really mirror the governor's goals. And now we have to talk about the difference in opinion on how we raise those revenues.
And the governor has every right to veto the bill. I mean, it's our hope. The three principals had two discussions today. They're going to continue to talk, we hope, tomorrow through the weekend. Still got 9 days to go here to pass a budget. And I am confident, as much as all the press here wants to see a shutdown, I'm confident that we're not going to get to a shutdown.
The majority party, the Democrat Party, just passed a budget that had a huge tax increase in it. In either budget, whether it be the governor's budget and the budget that was just passed, there are no real structural cost reforms. And quite frankly, that's what we need.
The vote last night followed Governor Murphy's angry 5 p.m. press conference yesterday. That's where he said he would not sign such a bill and accused the legislative leaders of shoddy work. A little before 9 o'clock last night, the two leaders emerged from their houses to support their budget and fire back at the governor for letting the talks break down.
I think the governor is, in fact, responsible in many ways for the breakdown. You know, he's taken a very dogmatic approach to resolving this. He's been disagreeable instead of disagreeing. And I think we had the opportunity to make a real progress today, and we failed.
This is my ninth budget. I have never seen an administration with a lack of focus and a lack of honesty the way they've handled this. We are funding the things he asked for. The only thing that isn't being fully funded is county colleges. And by the way, we're raising over $1 billion in taxes, which I really don't want to raise. But I would certainly rather tax corporations that got a windfall from Donald Trump than I would the people of this state.
So possible next steps are a veto by the governor, a conditional veto. He could sign the budget and line item veto certain parts of it, or he could resume talking to Sweeney and Coughlin.